Hey, Joe, you got to make that tape for Eddie.
You know, I've known Eddie for, been fortunate enough to know Eddie for almost 50 years. And they talk about the great baseball players being five-tool players. Well, Ed Bray, in my mind, he's a five-tool teacher. He's got intelligence, creativity, compassion, dedication, and most importantly, he could juggle. Has he been an inspiration to countless students? Forget about it!
Old black magic has me in its spell.
Old black magic that you weave so well.
It was not until I was up in front of a classroom on a regular basis that I realized how much of Mr. Bray's general, you know, approach to building a rapport with students that I was imbibing during that time. I have caught myself with like frightening frequency this year, saying to myself, like, that was a total Brayism.
What can I do? I hear your name and I'm a flame.
And I think that's how his teaching affected me as a student as well, and as a sort of a colleague, was that he was always willing to accept people where they were, and then from that place build them up to be something even better.
For you're the lover I have waited for.
You're the maid that fate has.
What I remember most about Mr. Bray is he really cultivated that authentic version of you, and he wanted to see that. He didn't want to see you try to be someone else or conform in any sort of way. He just wanted that true, unique person.
Loving the spin I'm in under the old black magic called love.
It was so incredible to see students who had seemed so quiet and seemed like they had nothing to say really be drawn out in his class and show that they had a lot to say.
Mr. Bray, as a product of the New York City school system, I was pretty proud of the fact that I made it through 3 years of high school without ever reading a book. That was until my senior year in 1982, when I ended up in your class. I have to say, your unconventional ways of teaching were a lot of fun.
In a spin, loving the spin I'm in, under the old.
His teaching style is a very, shall we say, engaging. He's very engaging.
All of us. I just remember your classes being so fun and creative and engaging, and you having just a passion for students and teaching.
If I can be that inspirational to students who are interested in English, then I think I can consider myself to be a successful teacher if that happens.
Hello everybody in New York. This is Ed Bray here live from Cane City, and I've got a group of students here that want to do some talking. We're going to turn it over to them, so without further ado, I'm going to pass the microphone down. Joe, I'd just like to tell you that I'll never forget what you and your brother Ray did to me, and my brother Mad Dog are going to meet you in a battle royale, so remember that.
Kick it! Sorry for tomorrow's youth. They won't get to experience your charisma and the energy that you bring to the classroom and to yearbook, and who could forget the soccer games?
You ask your mom, please, but she still says no!
You proceeded to go on and tell us all about whirling dervishes, and I didn't really believe you until in college one time. I was at a trivia night, and the final question was about whirling dervishes, and luckily, I remembered pretty much everything you said, and I won the game.
Money.
middle name Jackie, Jermaine, Marlon, and Tito, and Michael.
So there was one day we were voting on something, I don't know what happened, and I left my hand just like raised in the air, and the next thing I know, you know, I was being hauled on down to the Spanish class down the hallway, and then the best, kind of most hilarious part was always, you know, hearing the sound of someone dragging their desk slowly back to the classroom.
Like when you knew Ed was going to be a teacher.
When he was in the fourth grade and read every book that was going.
There's no comparison. There's no comparison. Mr. Bray has the best beard, hands down. Hands down. Cut that hair.
If I run for political office in the near future, I reserve the right to relentlessly beat my opponent over the head with the fact that my father was a high school English teacher for 36 years.
I remember a lanyard with about 800 keys on it. What do you have access to?
One, two, three, my baby don't mess around me.
Did you know that Pappy is retiring?
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he's been teaching for a long time. Yeah, yeah, I think you're right. Are you proud of Pappy?
Yeah.
Yeah. I wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you here at the state capitol in Denver. I've been trying to round up some support to make April 25th, Ed Bray Day, but as you can guess, there's probably not a lot of love up here for that. But I'm sure they'll celebrate it in Canyon City, in the Canyon City High School.
You think you got it? We're all proud of your accomplishment, and I just want to wish you very good luck on your retirement. And only one regret, is I never had you as a teacher. If what they say is nothing is forever, then what makes love the exception? So why yo, are we so in denial when we're not happy here? Y'all don't want to hear me, you just want to dance.
Congratulations! We're so proud of you! We can't wait to hear all of the wonderful things you are doing.
Just want you in my caddy.
I'm happy I love you. Congratulations!
All I can wish for you is the best of luck, and
L'chaim. Hey! I'm right now!
I wish the best for you. I know you'll do great things, and congratulations.
Thanks a lot for everything, Mr. Bray. And I hope that you have an awesome retirement.
Congratulations, and thank you for everything you did for us.
Lend me some sugar. I am your neighbor. Here we go. Oh, shake it, 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 shake it.
You really touched a lot of people's hearts. So, thank you for everything that you've done.
And lose the news. Shake it, shake it, baby doll. Shake it on the floor.
Hey, Ed Bray, man, what's left to say, but congratulations.
Always look both ways when you're getting in that roundabout, the new roundabout on 15th. I hear that it's pretty tricky. Straight up.